Next up, we have the pleasure of hearing from Medha Bandari. Medha is a 14-year-old student from Auckland, New Zealand. She is passionate about technology and won third place in a game development competition when she was 9 years old. Medha has also won second place for her Power BI data visualization and has presented in various Excel and Power BI meetups and New Star of Data conferences. In this session, she will share Power BI query tips for automating your data cleanup tasks.
Thank you, Deborah. Hi, I'm Medha Bandari, and I am so glad to be presenting at the Power BI Women's Summit. I'm very happy that I get to present at a platform that encourages women to work with technology. So a little bit about me. I'm Medha Bandari, as I said, and I have always had a passion for technology ever since I was a kid. I'm 14 years old now, and I'm a student at Mount Albert Grammar School in Auckland, New Zealand. So last year in lockdown, I started my own YouTube channel called NZ Tech Girl. And in this channel, I post coding videos for kids, and I also post beginner Excel videos. Recently, in the school holidays, I have started teaching at Kids Tech NZ's Coding for Kids classes, which are absolutely free. And I felt like that was a great opportunity for me to build on my skills. Yeah, and I also started presenting at meetups and events like this Power BI Women's Summit. And I started presenting at the start of last year, and I have really enjoyed that, so I think I'm going to keep going with that. And if you want to contact me in any way, my email is medhabandari@gmail.com. And my YouTube channel is NZ Tech Girl, so please don't forget to subscribe to that. And my LinkedIn is Medha Bandari, so do check that out. So in today's session, I'm going to be talking about three tips that you can use to automate your data with Power Query in Power BI. So the first tip is going to be how to extract data from folders and automate it. Next, we're going to learn how to apply a dynamic filter. And finally, we're going to learn how to create a date from the name of an Excel file. So my first tip is going to be how to insert folder data into Power Query and what you need to do in Power Query in order for us to automate our folder data. Okay, so first we go into Power BI and we go to Get Data and we're looking for folder. Now, if you don't have folder in there, then you go More. And when this pops up, you click on folder and go Connect. And go Browse, and then my files are in videos. So I'm going to click videos and Excel files. Yeah. Okay. So once I click OK, so this is going to pop up. I have sales data for 2017, 2018, 2019. I'm going to go Combine and Transform. So this is going to open up in Power Query Editor. So once it opens like this, I'm going to click Sheet 1 because that's where all my data is and it's all been combined together. This data is really messed up. It has its sales in supermarkets in Myanmar. So I'm going to go OK, and I'm going to fix my data in Power Query once it opens. OK, so this is my data. And over here is the queries tab that Power Query Editor has for us. So I'm going to start editing my data in transform sample file. Now, see, as you can see, the headers are kind of messed up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into Promote Headers in Applied Steps and X on that. And then I'm going to go to Transform and transpose this data. So once I transpose this, this is what it looks like. And I'm going to select the first two columns and right click. And I'm going to go Merge Columns. Yeah, so once I merge the columns, the separator is going to be space because that is what's in between my my two columns. And then it's merged. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to transpose this. And it's back together. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my first row as headers. So click on that little table icon and click on use first row as headers. So now that we've fixed up the titles, I'm going to go to the end and it says gender and type. Now I want to split this. So what I need to do that is I can just right click on that and where it says split columns by delimiter. So when I click delimiter, then it has space. That is my delimiter because that's what's separating both of them. So I'm going to go okay. And then here we have both our gender and our type separated. Gender, and I'm just going to rename them to gender and type. Yeah. So now that I've fixed that, what I want to do is I want to multiply the total and the unit price together. So to do that, I'm just going to select my unit price and my total. And then I'm going to go into add column. Yeah, and once I go on the add column tab, it says standard and click on multiply. When I do that, it does this for me. And now what I want to do is I want to round it. So I go into rounding and click round dot dot dot. And I want to round it to 2 decimal places. So I'll just type in 2. So now that I've rounded it, it creates an extra column for round, for the rounded. And I'm going to delete the multiplication and just rename this to total. So once I've done that, that's all I need to clean up for the data. So I'm just going to go, I want to add in another column. So I'm going to go to custom column and the formula that I'm going to use is date.year. And then I'm just going to delete the date that I've already written. Yeah. And then I'm going to open bracket. And then date. Okay. Date sold. And so you close the bracket and make sure there are no syntax errors and go okay. And so now it's created a year column for us. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to rename it to year. And now that we've fixed up our data, remember we've been working in the transform sample file. And we go to the actual file, it says it's an error. So what I need to do is I just need to click the X and then I'm going to delete source name. And this is what my data looks like. So now that I'm ready, I'm just going to close and apply. So yep, close and apply. So now our data has been loaded. What I need to do is I'm going to get a clustered bar chart. So just click on it and it should appear on your screen. So now I'm going to put my total and values of the bar chart. And then I'm going to take my year and put it into axis. So now this is what my data looks like. Right. So now that my data looks like this, if I want to automate it, I'm going to go into my Excel files. And in another file, I have got sales 2020. Now sales 2020 is not in there. So I'm just going to copy this, go back into videos and go into Excel files. And I'm going to paste it over here. And now let's see if we refresh our visualization. Let's see if it pops up on the bar chart. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on it, click refresh. Once I refresh it, there, an extra, our extra supermarket sales file has been added. Right, so that's how you automate data by inserting folder data. So my second tip is going to be applying a dynamic filter onto your data in order to make it easier for us to load it onto Power BI. First, we go into get data and more, and we're going to go back into the folder. Yeah, so once I do that, click folder and go connect. And then again, I'm using the same data, so it's in videos. I go Excel files, okay. So now that I've done that, it opens up like this. Now I also have the extra 20 in here too. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go transform data. So once I do that, it opens up in Power Query Editor. Now what I'm trying to do is, so where it says folder.files, this is the file name. So now I'm going to scroll right to the end, to where it says date created. So now what I want to see is I want to see like what was the most recent file that I opened. So to do that, I just need to click on the filter and then go into date / time filters, and then is latest. So once I click on that, you can see the most recent file that I've opened. And what you can also do is not only the latest, but you can also see many other things that you can do. You can go in the next is earliest, and there are many other things that you can also do apart from applying that filter. So that's all on applying a dynamic filter. So my final tip is going to be how to create a date with the name of an Excel file in order to make loading our data onto Power BI easier. By doing this, there are a lot of formulas in here, so just bear that in mind. So now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get that XLSX off of the sales. So as you can see, I'm using the same data. So to do that, first I need to split the column. So I'm going to right click split column and by delimiter. I'm going to go space because I'm trying to get the sales and the 2017 separated. So I'm going to go leftmost delimiter. Okay. And so see, I've split up the sales and the 2017.xlsx. So if I want to remove the xlsx, I'm going to go into custom column. So add column, custom column, and I'm going to rename this column to date. Now, the formula that I'm going to use is text.replace. Yep. And then I'm going to click on that and get rid of the text. Right. And then I'm going to open bracket and name. Yeah. So mine's name two, because name was one is sales and we don't want sales. We want to work with the 2017, 2018, 2019 SLXX. So, and then quotation marks SLXX, I mean SX, and then comma, and then quotation marks again, close the bracket, make sure there are no syntax errors. And here we are, it's created a date column for us. Now, what I want to do is I want the date as a number. So for example, for January 1st. So what I'm gonna do is, the formula for this is going to be hashtag date, and then I'm gonna open bracket, and then I'm gonna type in number dot number dot from. That's my next formula. And then after that, I'm gonna type another open bracket and then text.replace again. Yeah, so once I do that, I'm gonna go back to the end and then I'm gonna close the bracket and then I'm gonna remove the, I mean, put in a bracket where it says name. Okay, so make sure there are no syntax errors. Okay, now you can do this too, but I want my January in too. So to do that, I'm just gonna go comma one, and then close the bracket again. So, and then remove the bracket after name dot two. So make sure there are no syntax errors, go okay. And as you can see, now we've created a date column with the number of the year and the month. Now that comes to the end of our session. Thank you so much for listening to this. And I'd also really like to thank Power BI Women's Summit for giving me this opportunity to speak here. I hope everyone found my three tips helpful. And if you want to see more of my content, then please do check out my YouTube channel. And you can connect with me through email or LinkedIn. Thank you again.
Thank you for sharing methods for automating our data import task with Power Query, Medha.